Yes, dear student, today we are going to start our first practical. The title of the practical is Percentage of Iron in the Ore. Okay, one ore, hematite ore is given to you, powdered hematite ore is given to you, and from that today you have to determine the percentage of iron from it. Okay, so you are knowing iron, it is very important metal. Okay, in every industry it is based or it is built using the iron. Okay, iron, it is a one of the important metal in for the industry also or many other purpose also. Okay, so how iron is obtained from its ore? Okay, and for that it is necessary how much percentage of iron is present in that ore to determine. Okay, otherwise if you are going to determine the percentage of iron from any ore and it is not economical and profitable one, so it is not good for you. It is not good. Okay, so before to select the ore for its extraction, first you have to determine how much percentage of iron is present in that ore. Okay, so let us proceed further. Relevant program outcome, basic knowledge, already we have learned in the theory lecture, that is ore, mineral, gangue, flux. Okay, experiment and practice. Okay, you must be able to handle various glasswares, burette, pipette, conical flask. Okay, individually and in a team also. Okay, individual and teamwork. So just now as I said, you must be able to perform the experiment individually as well as in team also, and lifelong learning skill. Okay, what improvement we can do, or how easily we can determine the percentage, for that you must have that lifelong learning skill, then only it is easily possible for you people. Okay, so what are the competencies or practical skills developed after performing this experiment? That is the measurement skill, okay, handling glassware and calculation. These are the competencies which is developed in you. Okay, and obviously relevant course outcome, it is related to up to chapter number 4. So CO4 of that, it is the select relevant metallurgical process related to industrial application. Okay, so this is the CO related to this experiment. Practical outcome, in short, it is our aim or title. What you have to do? Standardization of KMnO4 solution using standard oxalic acid, and determine the percentage of iron in the given hematite ore by KMnO4 solution. And remember, this titration, it is also called redox titration. This titration, it is also called the redox titration. As we have seen in first semester also, under the heading redox titration, as it involves both reduction and oxidation reaction. So it is also called the redox titration. Okay. You have to follow some safety precautions. Okay, follow safe practices. Demonstrate working as a leader and team member. Practice good housekeeping. All these are the affective domain related outcomes. Next. Okay, so directly I am going to skip this part. Resources which is required for this experiment, that is the burette, round bottom flask. Here instead of round bottom flask, I am going to use the 500 ml beaker, wire gauze, conical flask, pipette, measuring cylinder, volumetric flask, sample chemicals like ore sample, fine powdered ore we have taken, KMnO4, potassium permanganate, sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, oxalic acid, zinc granules, they are needed for this experiment. So let us proceed further for the procedure. Procedure, it is divided into three parts. First part, that is the preparation of sample solution. Second is standardization of KMnO4, and part C, that is the determination of percentage of iron. Okay, so we will see the procedure step by step. So first we are going to start with the part A, that is preparation of sample solution. Yes, dear student, now here we are going to start the part A, that is preparation of sample solution. Okay, for that we need this electronic weighing balance, iron ore. Okay, we have this is our electronic balance. Place this weighing paper on it. Okay, now it will show you the weight of that paper. Now what you have to do, you have to make it 0 by using this tear button. Okay, so it will become the 0. It is not still 0, so again you have to tear it. Wait till that circle will appear here, so it means it is now stable. What you have to do, you have to take the 1 gram of ore. So take the 1 gram. Okay, so you have to take the 1 gram of ore, hematite ore. We are taking here 1 gram of hematite ore. See here, it is a 0. Is it visible to you? 0.609 gram. G is the unit, that is the gram. Add few more hematite ore, powder of hematite ore. Okay, slowly add. Try to take exactly 1 gram of Fe ore. Okay. It is 1.003 gram. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to transfer it. Now that 1 gram ore, it is transferred to this 500 ml beaker, and in that 100 ml sulfuric acid is added. And what you have to do, you have to gently heat it on the wire gauze. Okay, this is the wire gauze, this is called the wire gauze. Bunsen burner is on. Okay, it is kept for the heating. You have to heat it till complete ore is dissolved. Okay, you can see here, now it is kept for the heating. You have to wet till complete ore is dissolved. After complete dissolution of that ore, what you have to do, you have to add the zinc granules in it. Okay, now we will wait till it dissolve. Okay, now you can see our ore is completely dissolved now. Okay, so what you have to do, after complete dissolution of that ore, what you have to add? You have to add zinc granules. See, these are the zinc granules. You have to add these zinc granules in this dissolved ore sample and keep it for the heating for few minutes. Okay, already I have explained what is the role of zinc granules. Okay, we will heat it for few minutes, and after few minutes heating, what you have to do, you have to cool the solution. You have to cool this solution and transfer that solution into the 250 ml volumetric flask. Now I'm going to distill this using distilled water. I'm going to add the distilled water up to that mark. To that marking, you have to add the distilled water. It should not be added in excess, so take proper care. Now this is up to the mark. What you have to do? You have to decock here and shake well. Shake this solution well. Now this is your 250 ml sample solution. Okay?
This is your 250 ml sample solution. And this sample solution is used for the titration purpose. Okay, this is volumetric flask. Now we are going to start the second part of, that is part B, that is the standardization of KMnO4. For standardization of KMnO4, we need the KMnO4. We have to determine the normality of this KMnO4. Okay, this is your oxalic acid. Sorry, this is H2SO4. This is the oxalic acid. Okay, what you have to do? You have to take the 10 ml oxalic acid in this conical flask using this pipette. This is called the pipette. By using pipette, you have to take this oxalic acid, 10 ml oxalic acid. Okay, now I am going to take the 10 ml oxalic acid.
Up to this mark, here is also one marking. Okay, is it visible, ma'am? That marking, up to that marking, you have to take that 10 ml of oxalic acid, transfer it into this conical flask. Okay, you have to transfer it into the conical flask. Add 10 ml of sulfuric acid in the same conical flask. This is the measuring cylinder. Using measuring cylinder, I am going to add the 10 ml sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid I am using. Okay, 10 ml sulfuric acid. See here, this is the 10 ml. Transfer this into the same conical flask and heat it for the few minutes. What you have to do? You have to heat it.
Okay. Heat it for the few minutes. Okay. Up to 70 degree that you have to heat. 70 degree means don't boil the solution. Till that moisture get collected at the neck of that conical flask, you have to heat till. Okay. Yes, now temperature is reached to 70. Here we are heating it. Yes, now stop the heating and titrate this hot solution using the KMnO4. This is the burette. You have to fill this burette using the KMnO4 that we have to standardize. Okay, this is called the burette, and we are filling the burette with the KMnO4 solution. Please check the cork is closed at the bottom, otherwise solution will waste. Exactly adjust up to the zero mark. Okay, yes, the excess solution remove. Please remove the excess solution, ma'am. Yes, now it is exactly adjust to the zero. Okay, see this. This is the burette which is filled with the KMnO4 solution. Is it visible? Yes, now you fill the burette with the KMnO4 solution. You have to titrate this hot solution with that KMnO4. Yes, continue the titration, ma'am. Slowly, dropwise, you have to add. Wait. slowly you have to titrate this. This KMnO4 acts as a self-indicator. And what will be the end point of this titration? In the beginning, the solution is like water, colorless. After completion, it will turn to the light pink. Okay. Continuous stirring is necessary. Okay. Till light pink will remain in the conical flask. Continuous stirring is necessary. Now you can see the pink color is appeared in the conical flask. Now we are going to check the reading, burette reading. Yes, is it visible to you? It is 9.5. Okay. It is 9.5. Similarly, we have to take two more readings. Reading will be appear between this 9 to 10 only. Okay. So our first reading is 9.5. So where you are going to write this reading? In the observation table number 1, that is the standardization of KMnO4. So our first reading is 9.5 ml. Okay. Where you are going to write? In observation table number 1, that is standardization of KMnO4. Similarly, I said you have to take the two more reading, okay? And reading might be between the range 9 to 10 only. So one more I am going to take the same, okay? So you have to take out of these three, which two are the constant that you have to take here? So V2 is your 9.5 ml, okay? Now we are going to start the determination of percentage of iron, that is the Part C procedure, that is the Part C determination of percentage of iron. Okay, here, yes, fill the burette with the KMnO4 that is used for the standardization. Same burette, same KMnO4 is used in this burette. Okay, now what you have to do, that in first step we have prepared the sample solution. Okay, we have to take the 10 ml of that sample solution using the pipette in conical flask. By using pipette, take the 10 ml of that solution. Yes. Up to the mark, you have to take the solution. Now it is the 10 ml, transfer it into the conical flask. No need to use the external indicator. KMnO4 itself act as a self-indicator. Same like previous one, here also you have to add the 10 ml H2SO4 by measuring cylinder. By using measuring cylinder, add the 10 ml sulfuric acid. Yes. Okay. 10 ml sulfuric acid is added in the same conical flask. Only little bit change in previous step and this step is that during the standardization of KMnO4, you have to heat that conical flask. But when you are going to determine that sample solution using the sample solution, here directly you have to titrate. Okay, slowly add dropwise till the pink color, light pink color appear. Ma'am, please start this titration. Slowly I continue shaking is necessary. Yes, add it. Dropwise you have to add till light pink color will appear. Which indicator we are using here? Kamano 4 self indicator we are using here. Okay, this is step procedure part C is there. We are determining the percentage of iron. For this we use the sample solution which is prepared in the step 1 or part A. Okay. Continuous shaking is necessary here. You have to add Kamano 4 till light pink color will appear in the conical flask. Yes. Now stop the titration and see your reading. Yes. Check the, observe the burette reading carefully. Yes. Is it visible to you? Here 4 completed. Upper one is the 4. This is the below is the 5. And between 4 to 5, this is the 4.5. Okay, this is for you. And your reading is 4.5. Okay, where you are going to write this reading? You have to write this reading in your observation table 2. That is the determination of, you have to write it here in observation table 2, determination of percentage of iron. Our first reading is 4.5. Similarly, you have to take the two more readings which will come in the same range, okay, that is between 4 to 5. Okay, so this is about the experiment. Now we will do the calculation part of this.
Already we have completed our experiment in observation table number 1, that is the standardization of Kamano 4. Our first reading is 9.5. Yes, second reading is 9.7 and third reading is 9.5. So out of 3 readings, which 2 readings are constant, that we are going to take it here as a V2, that is 9.5 ml. Right, this is about the observation table number 1, that is standardization of Kamano 4 solution using oxalic acid. Okay, in second observation table we have taken the sample solution which is prepared in the step A, and during that titration our first reading, that is the 4.5, our first reading is 4.5, second reading it is the 4.6, again it is 4.5. okay, so same. Out of these 3, which 2 are constant, that we have to take it as a V3, that is 4.5 ml is our V3. Okay, now we are going to see the calculation part of this experiment. First part A, that is the calculation for the standardization of Kamano 4. Okay, see here, one formula is there, N1V1 equal to N2V2. What is N1? N1, it is the normality of oxalic acid, which is given to you because it is the standard solution, that is 0.1 normal. V1, that is the volume of oxalic acid. How much we have taken? We have taken it 10 ml using the pipette. Okay. N2, that we have to determine, that is the normality of Kamano 4, that today we are going to determine. And V2, it is nothing but, which is obtained in the observation table number 1, V2, that is 9.5. So put all these values here. N1V1 equal to N2V2. N1V1, these are the values of oxalic acid, and N2V2, it is the values of Kamano 4. So N1, what is the concentration? Okay. Go on putting the values of N1, V1. Value of N1, it is the 0.1. V1, that is the volume of oxalic acid. How much we have taken? It is the 10 ml. N2, we have to determine, that is the normality of KMnO4. And V2 is our 9.5. So, how you are going to calculate N2? So, 0.1 into 10 divided by 9.5. Go on calculation, you will get the values of N2. So, your answer is 0.105 normal. Okay, unit of this is the normal. So, this is the concentration of KMnO4. N2 you have determined. Okay, now part B, that is the calculation of determination of percentage of iron. Okay, this is the standard relation, that is 1000 ml, 1 normal KMnO4 is equal to 56 gram of Fe. From where this 56 is coming? This is from its atomic weight. The atomic weight of Fe, it is the 56. Okay, so 1000 ml, 1 normal KMnO4, it is required for the 56 gram of Fe. So, for this V3 ml means, which is obtained in the observation table number 2, V3 ml N2 normal KMnO4, we have to calculate this. So, go on putting the values of V3, N2 in the above equation, 56 into V3, V3 is our 4.5, okay, and what is our N2, N2 it is 0.105 divided by 1000, okay. Go on calculating this. So, go on putting the values here. V3 it is your 4.5. N2 it is 0.105 normal divided by 1000. When you are going to multiply this, you are going to get 0.02646 gram. This much Fe is present in 10 ml of core sample, because we have taken the 10 ml. Okay, so here also one correction is there in step 2. Instead of 10 ml core sample, 25, we have taken the 10 ml. So how much it contains? It contains this much gram of Fe. You have to write same value here also. Okay, if 10 ml consists this much, then 250 ml, how you are going to determine? For 250 ml, here also one correction is there. This is the value of Y. You have to multiply that Y by the 25. So, here instead of 10, you have to write it 25. Go on putting this value here. Same value you have to write it here and multiply by the 25. Okay, so what is your answer? Go on calculating it. So 0.02646 into 25, and your answer is 0.6615 gram of Fe. This is your Z. Okay, so this much of Fe, it is present in 250 ml of ore sample solution, which is prepared in the part A of that experiment. In part A, we have prepared the 250 ml of solution. And in 250 ml, how much ore sample we have taken? We have taken 1 gram. So, whatever present in 250 ml, that is present in the 1 gram of ore sample. So, 1 gram of ore sample, it consists of how much of Fe? That is 0.6615 gram of Fe. It's present in the 1 gram. If 1 gram consists of this much, so 100 gram ore, because we have to determine the percentage, so 100 gram of ore sample, it consists of 66.15 gram of Fe. Okay, so what is your result? The percentage of iron in the hematite ore is 66.15. okay, so what is your interpretation of the result? What is your interpretation? The hematite ore consists of 66.15% of Fe. What conclusion you are going to draw from this? You are going to say that this hematite ore can be economically and profitably used for the extraction of iron. Okay, so this is all about the, our experiment number 1. Here we have seen complete procedure, experiment also, and calculation part also. Okay, thank you.